Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
I would like to welcome you all to the launch of Broken But Blessed Ladies Ministry. Those who are streaming online through Facebook and YouTube, I pray that you will be blessed. Those who are here and in house, I pray that you will reach, you will be richly blessed. Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord. Breathe on me. Breathe on me. all to stand as we consecrate our hearts to the Lord in prayer. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord. So I want to read this passage of scripture, just two verses. Psalm 34, verses 17, 18, and 19. Three verses. The righteous cry, and the Lord heareth, and delivereth them out of all their troubles. The Lord is nigh unto them that are of a broken heart, and save it such as be of a contrite spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivereth them out of them all. So brethren, whatever you have, whatever broken situation where you have, we're coming today to just declare that we are blessed, we are empowered, we are victorious in Jesus' name. And so we're going to sing this song. He brought me out of the mire clay. He planted my feet on a rock to stay. He put a song in my heart to sing, a song of praise. Hallelujah. So we are victors this morning, and we're just rejoicing in the
That's you up, to make sure that you're whole, so that you can go forward and do more for him in the ministry, and for others to come in, to be nurtured and to grow, so that the kingdom can be strengthened. God bless you today. I wish you all a good conference, and I'll stay around until as long as I can to enjoy it as well. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Yeah. he's living in Montego Bay. And he said, the police said to me, you know who I'm going? And I said, yes. They said, he got shot. And I said, what? I said, he didn't think that he was my husband. I said, what were I doing in trouble in the Montego Bay? Anyhow, the person said, they are going to the hospital with him. And I shot about 5 minutes after the person called up and said, I have bad news for you, he's dead. And I said, my God. I turned full same time in the house. I picked up my oldest child was living with me. Then. The younger one was living with me. And I said, where are your father dead? And I said, what are his shoes there? He said, what is your shoe there? He said, well, you don't think you're finding me in the house. Where is Kunji that he catch up here? And I keep, you know? And I said, my God, what is this? You know? Mommy, calm down. He's not dead. Calm down. And something he said to me, go down there, man. He's not dead. Go down there. Speak to him when you go down there. Speak to him. And I said, God, Jesus. But anyhow, I called one of my church sisters. She was a church sister then. And her husband was. And I called them and they said, I'm coming right away. And they came and they brought me down there. When I went down there, I saw him with his eyes open. His feet was clenched and his feet were like this. And I said, you know what he said, speak to him, speak to him. And I lay the long day around the quarter, she said to me, and you know what man, and I said something to him. You know what fear came over me and I said, I just started crying. And I just fell down and I started crying. But God has been instrumental in all of this.
Yes.
God has, I could have lost my mind.
Yes.
Because
yes.
After this, I remember when I had to do the run around to do the preparation for the funeral and all of that. One day I got up and I took the bus and when I was in Patrick City then and when I went in the bus and away about did what I have to do I was going back home. I fly past my bus stop, I don't even realize that I reached my bus stop.
Yes.
And when I reached to the children, I said, what am I doing here? Because where I was living anyhow, but far from where I was living it was happening. So I came off and I come back. Somebody said to me, really warm to your youth, sir. He said, my husband died last night. And she said, my God, but you're a strong man. And anyhow, I went through that phase. I lost my father in, my husband died in 1999. In 2000, my mother died.
Wow.
My father died. My mother died, right. My mother died. It was devastating also. She was sick, yes. She was Alzheimer's and, you know, now we never need that. So the tumor on me, when she got to that stage, so I had to go through the process with her.
Yes.
I said, God has kept me and I went through.
Amen.
My father died in 2001. So it is 3 years old.
Yes.
I said,
yes.
God,
yes.
Why me? Yes. What is this?
Oh,
but God kept me.
Hallelujah.
And I went through. And when I think it was finished and everything is going back to normal, my son got into trouble with the law 2005.
Oh,
this one pulled me over now. Because when I went to the lawyer, they don't have no money now. And they were just making me the money to get money from now. The lawyer said, because your uncle told me, this is your uncle, you know? He said, well, it's 25 years you're looking at them. He said, I lie. The blood of Jesus, he will not go to prison. And I said, God, you have to come through for me this time, you know. God, but I'm guilty, I'm innocent, God, you have to come through for me this time.
Yes.
Because me now not a sweat but you, and I'm the only one now, so you have to help me. And God came through for me.
Hallelujah.
God came through for me.
Hallelujah.
He confessed to his brother and he said, oh, me, I have changed, you know.
Yes.
And I prayed, but God came through for me. The day when the court, when he went on ID parade first.
Yes.
The man said, but I don't want to know this man. I don't want to know him, I've never seen his face yet. And I said, to God be the glory.
Mm.
And God kept me through all of these challenges.
My God.
And I am here today to say,
yes.
I am stronger.
Yes.
Because my situation has made me stronger.
Yes.
And the doctor said, you have cholesterol problem, high cholesterol. You have high blood pressure. He said, the blood of Jesus. The blood can run through my vein and me have sickness at the body. He said, by his stripes I am healed. He said, yeah, God, keep the blood. I reject that in Jesus' name. Poor circulation. He said, blood, circulate down the name of Jesus. And today I must tell you, I am stronger and wiser than that. No more cholesterol. The doctor give me the pill and say, oh, go take it. And get the NHS car, you can get it cheap or whatever. And I went over and I googled it. It said it caused blood clotting in some persons. It caused this and it caused that. And I took the first dose and I put the rest in the evening.
Yes.
I am not taken anymore. I said, God, the word prove yourself to me. Wow. And today I am cholesterol free.
Set me on fire.
now. Let's give her a round of applause.
Everybody just wanted a piece of me, and I cried because they have a social worker that comes in
my mother, my stepmother. And I said, yes, send me back. And I come back to Jamaica. Brethren, I start having kids. Because I become promiscuous and look for love.
Yeah. I'm a bad feeling bad in a reverend.
I love me, I look for every time I start for love. Somebody takes something. Yeah. It was just like a bird come and pick him. Yeah. Like a crow just picking off me. You understand me? And my mother, she's working on bar. And you know, she never buy me in. Because she has 5 kids to my father. And she started having kids by age too. From 16. I stopped having my kids when I'm 35. I didn't get a childhood. And it's not for one person. It's for 4 different persons.
Yes.
You understand? Because I was searching for love.
Yes.
I was searching for love. And her boyfriend then, every time they come up to me, so I said, my God, what's that? Why are these men looking for me? I have a nice one. Then I said, God, this is it. If this man ever come and put his hand against me, I'll mash him down. Because I start a mad now. You understand me? And I tell you, the brethren, so many things. So many things are in perfect friend. I understand the sister Polly, you know. And she had that encouragement. But I didn't speak out everything. There was something. But one day God said, pep your face up in I now. I tell you, peers are going like that now. Andrea, you're the prince of the Red Sea. Cross over, but you're not the fierce in first. I didn't tell my family this year. This year, everybody in my family knew. All the Jada don't know. Because Jada knows your man. So I'm going to tell Jada. That's he was wisdom. But everybody knew. And then when I start having the rest of them, who molested them too. It's a family of molestation. It's an altar that needs to be broken down. When I spoke to my ancestors, my father used to molest them too. My brother molested my sisters. It's like everybody gets a touch. And I said, God, no man. It's when Reverend God is a broken but blessed group. He said, be away later now. Because I'm broken. I'm a broken. And I remember when I sat down one night and I write my father a letter from Paul. I mean, I apologize to him. He reached the point, I'm mature. This mother church here. This church here has taught me a lot. I remember when I come down here now, I'm Reverend singing this song, you know. And I said, God, I'm free to lift my hands. I'm free to say amen. I can't lift up my hand.
Get up and fast it. Just don't mess it. It's going to be alright. Sometimes
never was crying on the bus. And the school kids look at me and say, all right, mommy. So I'm not all right. Because I'm not telling them all right. All right. I don't need to do the other thing, Today that the Lord has made, yes. And I must rejoice. But sometimes we can't rejoice. Because I'm beaten. This is battle. And when I was going, my thing got easy. God said, Reverend, it's just a way to use their thing. We never see their closet. And it's empty temple property over there. And so I'm going to throw up the neck. He said, hang yourself kind of better. I mean, I said, come on, lift some rope, something there. And I said, I'm going to clear Reverend God. So I saw it. And God have a plan. When I went to the basis, I took the baby wasn't there that day. I cried for the whole time coming to work. And I kneeled down. I said, devil, I'm a liar, tell. I said, the blood of Jesus against you.
Thank you.
are blessed right here and on YouTube in their bosoms. I'm going to be giving now. I'm going to ask Rochelle to come and bless us up.
Yes.
We're going to be taking an offering on the rejoice to be generous. The
offering is that joy is going to be
that. Minister Joy, please.
Praise the Lord. Yes, praise the Lord. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And okay, the lady, when I was listening on Facebook, God doesn't know the wrong. I was pleased that Reverend Bishop Williams came and gave the greeting. It showed that a man is supporting the ministry. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And he understands the capacity of a woman and he testified of that. Shout change of climate and all these things. But I'm glad I am here. I am so blessed. Brethren, when I sat down and saw Raquel doing sign language, I said, this is what prayer does. This is a broken mother who prayed for a child. And she asked me help so that we should pray for our children. And so we're praying, though. I am happy for Sister Raquel today. Once again, give it up for Sister Raquel. Yes, ma'am. And I remember she always participated and she can sing too. So I'm happy that the Lord has went back for her and she's back into the ministry of God to give God the glory and the praise.
Just a blessing.
Shout
appreciate you. We just love you because you are indeed awesome and worthy to be praised. And as we come together, Lord God, as women, and Lord, to worship and adore you because, yes, Lord, we understand our brokenness, but your promises are true that you will bless us beyond measure. Lord God, I pray as they bring forth their offering today, that God, as you breathe upon it, as they sow into this ministry, I pray, God, that it will be used to the furtherance of this work. And Lord God, you will bless the givers. In Jesus' name I pray. Let the church say,
Amen.
and served as lay preacher. In her passion to advance the kingdom of God, this servant leader makes every effort to grow deeper in the Word of God. Her determination and edification resulted in certificates in biblical training from Whole Life Ministry Bible Training Center and from Children Evangelism Ministry. She also participated in the Billy Graham School of Evangelism in 1998. In response to the clear directive from the Lord to grow in grace and in knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, Eugenie Ffrench enrolled in the Jamaica Theological Seminary and graduated in 2004 with a Bachelor of Arts degree in theology and a minor in guidance and counseling. Subsequent studies undertaken by her include a diploma in education from Shorter Teachers College. That's where I work, sorry. A post diploma in school administration and management. And management from the Michael University. Take it up. And a Master of Arts degree in educational administration from the University of the West Indies, Mona. Also, when she's not undertaking the work of the church, Eugenie Ffrench is serving in her vocation as a teacher of religious education at the guide at the St. George's College. She's also the first vice president of the Jamaica Association of Religious Education Teachers. And what I'm not seeing here, she's presently served at St. George's Teachers College at the head, as head of the Department of Religious Education, and also as head of the Department of Guidance and Counseling. You see that? You see that? Yeah. Reverend Ffrench was a recent awardee at the Mother Church of God, God's 75th Anniversary Award Ceremony, in recognition of her over 35 years of faithful and dedicated service to the church and the service. What am I saying? In her desire to extend her scope of influence to serve and minister to the needs of those who seek her assistance, she was recently commissioned as a justice of the peace. Lifelong learner, passionate about serving God. Yeah. Reverend Ffrench is also committed to family values and has been married for 36 years to Anthony Ffrench and are the parents of their three adult children, Ramonia, Raquel, and Anthony Jr., and two granddaughters. In which both of us are a part, my life has never been the same.
Praise God.
Has never been the same. I call her my prayer mother. You see that? Woman can pray for me. She ever pray for me? Yay! Oh my God! Look here, it's when I pray for that woman, that's when I'm a friend, start to pray for me. I started to pray for the students and the college of and the Shorter Teachers College. Look here. Every day, man, I love that.
Amen.
I just love her. She's just full of so much compassion.
Amen.
So much compassion and care. it is easy for me to tell her what I may consider to be the deepest, darkest secret of my life.
Yes.
No judgment.
My God.
Just love.
Amen.
My God.
Amen.
We are blessed to have this woman share with us just now.
Great.
Let us just stand and give her a long round of applause as she comes to the Lord.
Praise God. greet all those who are online as well. Those in New York, those in Canada,
yes,
and all over the Summit country, the parishes. God bless you. And those of you who are present, we know we are still under orders in terms of COVID-19 protocol. So I think we have a good showing this morning that this ministry has had an effect on you. I'd like to acknowledge my sisters-in-law who they came all the way from Geisel in St. Catherine at the border of St. Mary and St. Catherine, and in order for them not to miss anything, they made sure they come before. Praise yes, God. And my husband has just brought him. Yes, praise the Lord. Praise God. Lord. So we put your hands together. Praise God for Brother Anthony Ffrench. Praise the Lord. I want to acknowledge my two daughters. My two daughters are a part of the ministry. You know, families can be broken too. But we are beautiful and blessed. Praise Jesus. Praise God. I want to thank God for Sister Rochelle, Sister Shaboya, Sister Taché, the young people. When Sister Rochelle called to say, Rev, I am coming, and I have, you know, called on Sister Shaboya and Sister Taché, and together they made a team to make sure that we are streamed live and to have our lovely voice and to see our ministry in praise and worship. God is good and awesome. When young people support a ministry like this, you know that you know God is in it. So thank you so much for you young people, Brother Raj, and to all those who testified. Oh my God, I couldn't stop crying. Sister Hyde, boy, you touched me, you talk about my business. Yes, man. And all Sister Laurice, you who testify, I can identify with your testimonies. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. God is awesome. But look at us now. Praise God. We are beautiful. I want you to take a look before I continue at the table. And I want you to see that we have a whole jar and we have one that is split right down the middle.
Yes.
And we have some pieces. Praise the name of Jesus. Some of them are fragmented.
Oh, that's true.
And these represent all the pain and the troubles that we have been through.
Yes.
Yes. Pieces. Wherever you are scattered this morning. Even if you are a piece, God is still good and wonderful. You are still beautiful and blessed for your brokenness. Praise God. So, broken but blessed. How did this all begin? On April 4th, I was at work. I was in my office. And the Holy Spirit just came into that room with fire. He came and he spoke decisively, and he spoke, you know, with such, you couldn't miss it, and you couldn't miss hearing it. He was direct, and he spoke many things to me. But one of those things that he said was that I should lift up broken women, scrape up their broken lives, and pick up the fragments. Show you the fragments.
Yes, yes.
So we realized that the woman that God was indicating to me that needed picking up, they were at different places and they were in different categories.
Yes.
And God was specific. He said, woman. And I wondered, why me? That was the first thing I asked him. Lord, I am still going through my own brokenness. But why me? How am I going to lift up persons, a woman? My God. But he said, you are the one to lift them up. And I have been praying about it from April of 2019.
Yes.
But last year, I prayed again. I was praying, and the Lord was very angry with me. He said, why don't you do it?
Yeah.
And that very day, Minister Young called to talk to me about something else. And I meant mentioned it to her because I was becoming very concerned, you know, that I was disobeying God. And she said, broken women are in the place where you serve, so why not start there?
That's right.
And that's exactly what I did. And so we were in the lockdown, and we started, as you heard Sister Hyde said, we started on WhatsApp, a group of about four or five of us. And I realized that the Lord was calling me to pour into these women using His word. And so on Mondays we would have what we call the broken manna, where the word would be broken down in an emotional format. And on Wednesday we started doing voice note prayers, and we prayed for each other, yes, as they give their requests. Yes. And persons would just pray spontaneously. And so we started. And as we moved along, we moved into Zoom prayer on Wednesday morning at 5 o'clock. You know, yes, women wake up early, but yes, we wake up early in the morning at 5 a.m. And for an hour, we went before God and we prayed. And we become a support to each other. And the ministry grew from about four to we have over 45 persons. And these persons are here in Jamaica and abroad. And we give God thanks for that. And so we realize that women hold a prominent place in the heart of God. The Bible is replete with God's powerful message. Amen. Of His healing generally. But God's message in the Bible also recognizes that women are special. They are powerful and they are useful to God and others. And therefore He said, and is saying today, lift them up, straighten them up, pick them up from where they have fallen. I have heeded His instruction. I have followed His command. And I have been doing just that. So today I just want you to give an understanding of what it means to lift you up, what it means to lift up. And I want you to be patient with me as I go through this. And then I'm just going to look at a scripture.
Hallelujah.
That will just cause us to hear what God is saying to us. What does it mean to lift up? When we lift something up, it means that thing has fallen. And so you either have to move it from where it has fallen,
yes,
to put it back in place.
Yes, yes.
Or you have to lift it. Sometimes you can push it. Other times you have to lift it up. Praise the name of,
yes,
Jesus.
Praise
so God. Some women are knocked down and they are left in a place where they have been knocked down. Many have been knocked down, but they are still there in that place.
Yes.
Their self-esteem needs elevation from ground level to where God is calling them to,
yes,
heights of self-worth.
Yes, yes,
because,
yes,
when you are knocked down,
yes,
you know, you feel as if that you are nobody, especially if you don't have persons to come and to help you get up again.
Right.
Your pride and your self-confidence have been knocked down as well.
Yes.
So what are examples of these women that need the lifting up? They are those with low self-esteem, rejection, broken and bitter women,
yes,
whose emotion and psyche has,
yes,
been trampled on.
Oh.
Married and unmarried women, those deprived of education.
Uh-huh.
When I set foot on the campus of the University of the West Indies,
yes,
I made sure to walk, do a deliberate walk on the grounds. Because I didn't realize that I would get there. Praise the name of Jesus. But I did a deliberate walk on it. And I prayed and I said, thank you, Jesus, that this ground received you, Jenny. So some of us, we need to be lifted up. Yes, from where we are educationally to where we ought to be. Praise the name of Jesus. And what does it mean to pick up the fragments? The parts certainly need picking up, and the work has to be done to piece them together again. In this category, parts of the life of each woman who is on the floor. It is right where it fell, and these need to be picked up and replaced to make the woman whole again.
Amen.
She may appear to be all right, don't it? A lot of times, you know, we look at people in their vestments, their clothing, and we say, okay, she's fine, she's okay. But that woman, her emotion needs to be lifted up.
Yes.
And to be picked up.
Yes.
From where it has fallen. So a lack of education needs to be picked up. Loss of a child or husband, or the woman experiencing all these unfaithfulness in marriage, difficult marital relationship,
yes,
they need to be picked up.
Amen.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And God know that you need some picking up.
Amen.
And so you have told somebody.
Yes.
Who has,
yes,
been through that,
right now,
who he has,
right,
picked
here,
up,
right here,
to ground,
right,
level,
right now,
to bring somebody to the place where they understand that you are not alone. Hallelujah. Because when you are down, oh, some people see it as a time when they can just keep you down. But your Father knows where you are today. He knows where you are. He knows from where you are falling. And he's not judging you today. Praise God. Hallelujah. Scrape up. Some of you need scraping up. Some of you need a tune to help to give you up from where. You've been in that situation for so long that you need a shovel. You know, you need that shovel to come and scrape you off from that place. To bring and to put back your pieces together again. Hallelujah.
Right there.
In some instances, the situation has been going on so long that you lost a sense of who you are.
Right there.
You have been shattered. What the songwriter says, shattered, but I'm still not broken. How can that be? It had to be God in your life. Shattered to pieces, but you're still not broken. You saw a sister Hyde today that she was confident in who she is. Still going through, but confident. That's the mystery. Oh, that we carry when we carry the power and the fire of God. And this category of scraping up definitely needs some time. So that we need to take time with each other. The woman needs to take time with herself. And those around need to take time with her to pick her up. Some of you have been kicked around by those who have no time to care about you and your needs. Or your missing pieces. Praise God. Your pieces fly off when you fell. And persons just kick it even further. Oh my God, there's no help. Hallelujah. Praise God. But today, you are hearing that God is here to lift you up, to pick you up, and to scrape you up. It doesn't matter where you have been or what you are going through today. So the abuse women, all forms of abuse, you need a scraping up today. Those who have been sexually molested and abused, verbally, physically, emotionally. It's gonna take time. Because when these things happen to an individual, it follows them throughout their lives. You remember it forever. Somebody intruded into your personal private space. Hallelujah. God wants to make you whole again. Rejection. Those who have been rejected by family members. Parents. That's a difficult part, you know. When you are rejected by your mother or your father. Yes, or those who, you can imagine as a woman, your mother brought you into this world. And then she rejected you. She cast you aside as if you don't exist. Or for those who, she didn't want to, she got pregnant when she was a teenager. And that negative emotion that she carried, it was deposited in you from you were in the womb.
Yes.
And then you came out and you carried
heart well. But today, you may be fractured. You may be smashed and shattered, crushed, split. You may be burst open. You became damaged and injured. Something, an accident happened and your life was interrupted and has been interrupted. But today, that's in the past. The word that God gave when you visited me said, broken woman, that's past. Your brokenness is in the past and you have lived from it from then and some are still going through it. But God called it broken. Hallelujah. You can be made whole again. You can be made whole. Thank God there is hope. There is grace. You have been gracefully broken. The grace of God that bringeth salvation has appeared to all men and also to you today. There is power in the word of God. And that's the word that is going to pick you up and to lift you to where you are to be. So I just want to turn your attention this morning or this afternoon to a scripture. And before I do that, I just want to say that the Broken But Blessed ministry has a vision. And the vision is to heal and to bring wholeness to those who have been broken. And the mission is that every broken woman is, we are on a mission to lift them up, to scrape up their broken lives, and to pick up the fragments left by all the abuse and all that they have been through.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. No matter what is happening in your life today, those suffering from rejection and relational problems of every kind, in order that you can come into God's blessings, the blessings of salvation and divine destiny. But it needs hands. That needs hands. And the master potter desires to repair the vessels that have been broken today. How a vessel is made? God made sure to invite Jeremiah down to the potter's house. And God said, Jeremiah, I want you to observe what is happening when a potter makes a vessel. He showed him what was happening. And God said that he wants to do with Israel what he has done with what the potter is doing on the wheel. God wants to do with you. Yes, what a potter does on the wheel. When there is a broken piece, when peace is broken up, when the fragments are there, when the pebbles are in his pottery.
Yes.
He puts it back on the wheel and he turns that wheel, he puts some more clay on it and he never stops until that piece of pottery is pieced together in a way that will make that pottery beautiful.
Yeah.
There is a wonderful story in the Bible that recounts God's grace, you know. To this morning, you listen to the song, Gracefully Broken, you know, ministered by Racquel.
Oh,
means God's love. Grace means God's love, God's kindness, God's favor, God's grace and mercy, his unfailing love, his beauty and his loyalty. That's what grace means. And here in the text, we see Jesus, who the Apostle John boastfully speaks about. He said that he and the other disciples beheld his glory full of grace and truth. And he is the one who is here today to pick you up from where you are.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. I want to tell you about a man or a boy at the time when he fell. That and use it to help you to understand that you can be made whole again. So 2 Samuel chapter 4 and verse 4 says, Jonathan, Saul's son, had a son whose feet were crippled. He was 5 years old when the news of the deaths of Saul and Jonathan came from Jesse. And the boy's nurse picked him up and fled. But it happened that while she was hurrying to flee, he fell and became slave. His name was Mephibosheth. His nurse dropped him at 5 years old as they tried to escape from a situation. He fell. And so this morning I'm asking, who dropped you?
Ah, my God, right there.
Who dropped you?
Right there.
Hallelujah. As news of the defeat of Israel to the Philistines, and in particular Saul and Jonathan, sent the palace in panic mode. Praise God. Everyone in the palace acknowledged that he or she would be killed according to the custom of the time. And here was Mephibosheth's nurse trying to escape. And because he was a young boy, she lifted him up and she ran with him. But somewhere along the way, as she tried to escape, he fell from her grasp.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Bad news came from Jezreel. I don't know about you today. You may be getting a bit of bad news. You heard Minister Young testified that the bad news came to her that her husband was dead. Anybody know how it feels to get a bad news? I do. You get a bad news from your doctor. You get a bad news about your child. You get a bad news about your husband. You get a bad news about some person in your family. Bad news came from Jezreel. This family has been through a catastrophic situation. Father dead, grandfather dead, husband dead. Bad news. Bad news. Bad news. Hallelujah. That was Mephibosheth. So he started out at a disadvantage. Mephibosheth was disadvantaged from he was 5 years old. Hallelujah. And as a result, he grew up crippled. He was now dependent on the mercy of others. In fact, the name Mephibosheth means dispeller of shame. What a name. What a name.
Oh.
He must have had a difficult childhood. And such were some of us.
Yes.
We've been through the mill. Somebody dropped us. Some mother didn't do the nursing that she was supposed to do. Some father weren't supportive and giving his financial assistance. Hallelujah. Who dropped you today? Who dropped you? And from where have you fallen? David, he said, David, I know that the anointing is on you. promise. And so he asks, oh God, Jonathan says, do not ever cut off your kindness from our family. David, remember that. Oh, mighty God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And there was a zebra. Anybody know about divine connectors? Ah, the scripture said, there was a servant of the house of Saul. The servant was still in the house. Saul dead and Jonathan dead. Oh my God. And Saul had a son died. They murdered him. But the servant was still in the house. Somebody knew about the family situation. And so the servant said, Ziba said, somebody said there is a servant in Saul's house. Just the servant left in the house. Whose name was Ziba? So they called him to David. And the king said to him, are you Ziba? He said, I am your servant. And the king said, is there no longer anyone left? David repeated the question to him. Is there still anyone left of the house or the family of Saul to whom I may show the goodness and graciousness of God? Anybody know about the grace of God? Hallelujah. He wants to show your kindness today. Doesn't matter your age group or the stage at which you are at. So Ziba was summoned. There's a Ziba for everybody. Ziba shit.
Yes.
Ziba represents your divine connectors.
Yes.
The ones who will represent your case.
Oh, yes.
To the king.
Yes.
The ones who know where you are and what your circumstances are. The ones who God has set up to announce you to great men. Pray for your divine connectors. Pray. I remember some years ago that I started praying for my destiny helpers and my divine connectors.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Sometimes all you need is a Ziba. Praise the name of Jesus. So Ziba said, there is still a son of Jonathan. One whose feet are crippled. Hallelujah. So Ziba said, yes. One relative is left. Jonathan's son. But he's crippled. This is not the one suitable to come into your kingdom. That's what Ziba was saying. Isn't that what has been said and has been said about you?
Yeah. My God.
She don't look good.
My God.
She don't look good to be in a palace.
My God. My God.
She doesn't meet the standard of those who sit with kings.
My God.
She doesn't articulate well.
My God.
She's lame, halting. Crippled as a result of the fall, dejected and broken. People passing you.
Yes.
Don't you feel that way sometimes?
Yes. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Your movement is slow because you're crippled. But David didn't focus on the latter part of what Ziba reported to him. David was not interested in the condition of the Mephibosheth and the crippled state. So the king said to him, where is he? Bring Mephibosheth. I want to see him. Somebody is calling for you today. The king is calling for you today.
Hallelujah.
Where are you today, ladies? And Ziba replied to the king, he is in the house of Makir, the son of Amiel in Lodibar. Where are you today? Where are you today? Are you in Lodibar? Are you in Makir's house? Hiding so that you know, those who have killed your family don't come and attack you or kill you as well. Makir's house is a house of refuge. And some of us have been living on the mercy of the Makir's, the place where Makir lives. Maybe Lodibar, but it is a safe place and it has been a safe place for you. From your hunters. So Lodibar means no pastor. Mephibosheth lived in Lodibar for about 15 to 20 years. He was in that state, hiding away, crippled in his feet, deformed. Life seemed hopeless. wilderness, a place where he was misunderstood. Nobody stopped to check and to see that here was a man who had fallen from he was 5 years old. All they can see is what you are doing now, what you say now, how you look now. Praise God. But David sent for him. Lodibar means no word, no life, no revelation. Lodibar is a lonely place. Hallelujah. Lodibar is a place where people make assumptions about you without knowing your circumstances. But God is about to call you out of the box. He's calling you from the back to the front. He has the power to take you higher. He's ready now to pick you up. God's plan is to lift you up and out of Lodibar, from your lonely place. You may be married, but lonely. Hallelujah. Everybody moving on with life, but what about me? Hey, well, I am here to tell you that the place that you are in is not befitting the name they give you. Hallelujah. You are not your condition. You are not crippled. You know some people short, they call them shorty. But you are not your condition. Hallelujah. You are not what people label you to be. You are what God has said you will be. And today you are coming out. You are coming out of Lodibar. You are coming out of loneliness. You are coming out away from where they misjudge you, where they cast you aside. Then King David sent word and had Mephibosheth brought from the house of Machir. Hallelujah. I don't know how many of you are in the house of Machir today. But when the king summons you, you don't have to worry about how you're going to reach the palace. Hallelujah. The important thing is that somebody will carry you from where you are, your place of shame and pain.
Amen.
From Lodibar. Somebody will carry you. Somebody will announce you to the king. And somebody will carry you. Because you must reach the palace.
Right there,
sir. Hallelujah. And so when Mephibosheth reached the palace, he answered, "Here is your servant." He fell down in reverence. He thought that, yes, me dead now, because the king sent for me, and I am one that is left of the house of Saul. Yes, I represent the former dynasty, and my life may be at jeopardy. But I like Mephibosheth's faith. He went from Lodibar. You won't know what you will meet in the palace unless you move from where you are. You have to get some crazy faith and move out from Lodibar. You never know if you will reach the University of the West Indies if you don't try, if you don't make a move, if you don't try to get your foundation subjects.
That's right.
Hallelujah. So you heard the profile, but when I was in my 30s, that's when I did my CXCs. Hallelujah. Yes, man. You have to move by faith. Hallelujah. Yes, the children were already born, and there were financial situations. But I must leave Lodibar. I realize that there is more in me than I thought about myself. And so David called Mephibosheth by his name. God knows your name, ladies. It's time for you to begin to worship, even though you are timid, even though you are unaware of what the outcome of being carried to the palace might be. Worship. Begin to worship. Begin to praise God. Begin to thank him. Oh, begin to give him your life in Lodibar. And David said four things to Mephibosheth. He said, one, do not be afraid. Two, I will certainly show you kindness for the sake of your father Jonathan. Three, I will restore you to all the land of your grandfather Saul. Lord have mercy.
Jonathan's seed. And you shall always enter my tail. Praise the name of Jesus. Like my fever shed, you see, you're crippled. You see your broken life. You are told about your crippled state. Many disrespected and slighted you. But you were never told about your inheritance. Before you were dropped, you were never told about Jesus. You were never told about his precious love. You were never told about his kindness. You were never told how much he loved you. You were never told how beautiful you are. But David said,
hallelujah,
hallelujah. I am going to give you every piece of your property.
Yes.
That's all left.
Wonderful.
You will inherit it.
Yes.
Mephibosheth, it is yours.
Yes.
I don't know what is in the pipeline for you, but I know that if God has called you from your brokenness, that there is something that is awaiting you.
Amen.
Once you are called to the palace, you must get what you are called here to do. There's ministry in some of you because of your broken life. There's ministry in you because of your rejection. It's restoration time.
Hallelujah.
You are the king's child today. You have destiny wrapped up inside of you. It doesn't matter how the label that they put on you. Sickness may be rocking your body. I remember when the doctor diagnosed me with cancer. There was a fire that just rise up in me. I say I've been through a lot already. I have been dropped already in many times and in many different places.
Yes, yes.
And Satan, me don't know how me a go out. But me I say, cancer, you not kill me. Yes, I look into the face and I say, cancer, you won't kill me. I'm on the way to the palace. I'm on the way to my destiny. I'm on the way to my ministry. Hallelujah. 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 So woman, the situation may look great. Oh, my fever shelter fell face down. I said, what is your servant that you would concern for a dead dog like me? Some of you have called yourself a dead dog. You're useless. You're just one dog. And some people don't treat them dog well enough. Worse when they're dead. Some dog not get no ceremony. I know in some places, dogs get them ceremony. And some dogs are left an inheritance. But some are just left on the road. And then the sun bake them until their bones wash out. And so some of you feel like you're just useless. But I come to tell you something today, that God has seen purpose in you. Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You've been crippled for a long time. You've learned helplessness. As some psychologists said, you know, some people, their deliverance come like a fever shit. And the gate is open. And they just sit there refusing to move out of their place. Yes, they've become comforted in that place where they were dropped. Where they are fallen,
yes.
Where they have been broken. mistreated you wrongly. Those who have mistreated you. Mighty God. God is sending you back with a word in your mouth for those who dropped you and left you where you fell.
Speak, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Even after the pronouncement, you are still saying, I'm just a dead dog. But I want you to touch yourself today. COVID-19 protocol doesn't allow for us to touch somebody, but touch yourself. Touch yourself today and declare that I am in the palace now. And everything is possible. I am in the palace and everything is possible. Praise the name of Jesus. God said to the Apostle Paul, well, after three times going to him, for the thorn to be removed from him, God said, my grace is sufficient for you, Paul. Stop looking at the condition. Stop looking that you don't have a career now. You can start right where you are.
Amen.
And you can make something beautiful of your life. You can become everything and anything God wants you to be.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Rejection won't stop you. So the king summoned Ziba, Saul's servant, who was living in the palace and enjoying it all for himself. And David says, I've given you, given your master's grandson, everything that belonged to Saul. And to all his house, you and your sons and your servants shall cultivate the land for him. And you shall bring in the produce, so that your master's grandson may have food to eat. What a word. What a word. So Mephibosheth was brought from Lodibar, that no pastor land, where he was hiding out, and brought right back into where he ought to be. Where others were enjoying his success. Ah, yes, Lord. For his divine power has bestowed on us everything necessary for life and godliness. That's what the scripture says. And after you have suffered a while, the God of all grace, who has called you to his eternal glory in Christ, will himself restore you, secure you, strengthen you, and establish you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Mephibosheth, you are in the house today. The king is saying, you will always eat at the table. Your time of hunger is over. Your time of rejection is over. Jesus has come to your rescue. Hallelujah. From Lodibar to the palace. From dead dog hiding away in a land of no pasture to eating with the king at his table. You still have evidence that you were dropped. Somebody dropped you. For the scripture said, Mephibosheth lived in Jerusalem, even though he walked around in the palace on crutches. Hallelujah. So when they heard Mephibosheth coming to the palace, the crutches would make a noise. They are able to hear you now. They are able to see you now. You're moving away from where you have fallen, and you have moved into the palace. And though you may have little pieces of brokenness, but you have been pieced together perfectly by God himself. He has found all your pieces. You are now in the palace. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Mercy, grace, blessings, wealth, sufficient. Yes, not scraps. Not Bartimaeus. Jesus is calling you from your past life. Crippled, yet still you are rising. Gracefully broken.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So today you can consider it nothing but joy.
Hallelujah.
My sisters, when you fell into various trials, be assured that the testing of your faith produces endurance. You know what endurance is? Spiritual maturity and inner peace. Hallelujah. So let endurance have its perfect result and do a thorough work so that you may be perfect, so that you may be mature, completely developed in your faith, lacking in nothing.
Hallelujah.
I want to close this afternoon as I turn your attention to 2 Corinthians 4, 6 and 10. It says, for God who said, let light shine in darkness, has made this light shine in your heart, so we could know the glory of God that is seen in the face of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is making all the difference today. We now have this light shining in our hearts, but we ourselves are like fragile clay jars containing this great treasure. This makes it clear that our great power is from God and not from ourselves. We are pressed on every side by troubles, but we are not crushed. We are perplexed, but not driven to despair. We are hunted down, but never abandoned by God. We get knocked down, but we are not destroyed. And though and through suffering, our bodies continue to share in the death of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus may also be seen in your body, in my body. Hallelujah. That's what makes a difference today. As you are called to the palace, the glorious light of Jesus is shining in your clay jars, in your vessels.
Hallelujah.
Bless the name of Jesus. So you're a priceless treasure. You're a priceless treasure today. Knowing God's glory through faith in Jesus Christ, you're kept in fragile containers of human beings. You face enormous suffering, but you are not wiped out. You may be crippled, but you are called to the king's palace. You are called to the king's table. What an honor.
What an honor. Indeed.
Now people can talk about you. Now you are going to see everybody who rejected you come running after you. That was one of the things that God said to me. You see when you look beautiful, like this clay pot, your whole everything put together, they can see the lines and the little cracks because God covers those with his grace. Hallelujah. Those are covered by his grace, covered by his love. Yes, your sicknesses, your trials, your temptations, your abuse, your different paths that you have trod, you know, as you try to find yourself, the pieces are there. But they have left a masterful design on you that makes you unique and special. That's what makes you who you are. So in the face of your trial, you can still triumph today. Praise the name of Jesus. So we are pressured in every way, hemmed in and edged in, but not crushed. Perplexed, unsure of finding a way out, we are not driven to despair. Hunted down and persecuted, not deserted to stand alone. Some of us, we are living in families, but we are still lonely. Some of us live a lonely life for years, and we have people and relationships, but God is our friend this morning. And I want to say to you ladies, as you have come, as this ministry has been launched and established, that you are vessels full of power. That the woman with the alabaster box, she knew how to pour out what God has poured in her as she lived with him in the palace. She crept up behind Jesus and she poured out. She broke it. She emptied herself before poured Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. She poured her love on him. Why? Because he was the only one who saw her in her lowly bar. He was the only one who saw her when her name meant shame. He was the only one who picked her up and scraped her up and lifted her up when nobody else could do it. And so she poured everything, her worship, her praise on him. She gave him everything. Your vessels of power today. And so you don't have to even speak to your Simons. Because here was Jesus invited to eat at the table of Simon, and all his bigwig friends were there. But this woman burst into the room. She broke into that space because Jesus had now done a work on her. Hallelujah. There was no more shame. There was no more guilt. She had full confidence in who she is or who she was. She knew that she was not beautiful. She knew that she had a beautiful design. Her bow says that you are blessed. And she burst into that room, into that space where she should not have been, because she had faith in the one who came into her life. How about you today? Are you so bold to go find the king? Oh my God. The king was at the table. And she went. And she honored him before his friends. Yes, she knew how to be grateful for what God did for her. So she opened up her life and she gave him everything. She would give Jesus everything. Can you give Jesus everything? You can give Jesus everything without holding back. Ah, he won't judge you and he won't misjudge you, because from eternity past, from the time he created you, he knew what you were going to become. And so the Simons are saying, if he only knew what kind of woman, what kind of woman she is. If she only knew, and everybody was saying, if he only knew, if he only knew, he knows who you are. So Jesus stepped out, and Jesus said, leave her alone. Hallelujah. You don't have to worry about your Simons. You don't have to worry about those who are labeling you. You don't have to worry about those who think that you are not worthy to be in the palace. You don't have to worry about those who think that you don't deserve where you are. Ah, boy. When I got the job up where I'm working now, somebody said, Eugenie, I hope you get a job at the school.
Hey.
Ah, yes, God. But God. Look at where today. God bless you, those who are online. God bless you. God bless you. You are beautiful and you are blessed. You are destiny within you. Jesus.
I just wonder, Sister Eugenie, you're going to have to pray for the ladies. Whoever needs special prayer, just stand where you are. As Sister Eugenie just minister to you in prayer. Afterwards, we're going to have a special prayer of blessing over the ministry of Broken But Blessed. And then we have refreshment. Please don't go.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, go get some internal food now.
The love for you know.
The love for you. Bless the name. But just stand where you are. If you need special prayer,
hallelujah.
I'm already standing.
Hallelujah.
I need special prayer. I know what the Lord God is with.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Somewhere that says you may feel down and feel like God has sorrow for God. That you are faced with circumstances you can't get through. Right now, it seems there's no way out and you are going under. But you have proven. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, hallelujah. We give you praise, God. Hallelujah. We thank you for who you are today. That you are the great and mighty God. And you have called your women servants to this place at this time.
Hallelujah.
Because you knew where they were. And you know where some of them are right now. You saw those, you have seen those online. You saw where they were before. And you know from where they have fallen. And you have done some picking up already. And you are still doing the picking up. Oh God, we thank you that you are the picker up on this morning. Oh, this afternoon. Oh God, you come to pick us up. Lord, it is in your heart to pick up women from where they have fallen. And so Lord, I give you these women. You know each of them by name. David called Mephibosheth by his name. Oh God. He didn't know him. But he called him by his name. Some of us have not been called by our name. Oh, nobody knows us. Oh, mighty God. Oh, yes, God. Nobody understands us. Oh, but you're calling each woman. Oh, God, as they stand by faith this afternoon, you know where they are. And you know, oh God, where they need to be. And so I pray right now that your loving arms will nurse them. Lord, and after you have picked them up, some have been picked up, some need nursing, some need comforting, oh, some need a shoulder to cry on, some need a comfort, oh, mighty God, that nobody else can give. Pick them up right now, Father. Lord, you understand their pain, you know their rejection. Oh, God, you listen to the testimonies today, and some are still crying from their place of Lodibar. Oh, but you have touched with the feelings of all of their infirmities this afternoon. Pick them up, God. You already desire to do it. You will to do it. You say you will do it. You only need some more hands to do it. And so, Lord, I pray for them right now that as you nurse them back to full recovery, that they will understand that you have already done it. Rescue somebody. Save a woman today. From suicide. Rescue somebody, Lord. Oh God, from despair. And set them on their way rejoicing. Lord, you know those who are saying I didn't go to school because somebody dropped me. Somebody didn't care for me. I am uneducated. I can't find a good job. Oh my God, you see those ones today. Lord, you see the ones who have lost their husbands. Oh, God, and they are saying, will somebody look at me that way again? Oh, my God, some are lonely. Lonely, Lord, you see them where they are today. Rescue them today, mighty God. Pick them up, oh, God, and put your arms, your loving arms around them. Help them to feel special today.
Hallelujah.
Lord, you said that even in old age, they shall be fat and flesh. God, some desire to get married. Oh God, some desire companionship.
Yes,
yes,
today. Great men. Oh, provide destiny helpers. Lord, you know those who are sick, hurting, and tired of being sick and hurting. Minister to those who are sick today. Oh God, I pray against every sickness and diseases. Oh God, as you died, so that those who are broken physically may be healed. Oh God, your healing is a children's bread today. Heal those who need your healing today. In the name of Jesus.
Yes,
lift up your people today, God.
Yes, God.
Lord, you know everyone. Those who are falling.
Yes,
because
God.
Somebody dropped her.
Jesus.
A woman has been dropped. A woman has offered everything. Oh, God. Yes, she gave all. But somebody dropped her. Lord, I want you to pick her up today. Oh, God, anoint that one afresh. And breathe fresh life into that body. In the name of Jesus. Lift up the woman today, Lord. Lift them up, pick them up, and scrape them up today. So that today we can rejoice. We can say we are beautiful, we are blessed, and we are women full of power, full of grace. Yes, because Jesus, the Holy Ghost, resides in us. Remember those who are struggling with their faith. Oh my God, draw alongside them today. And remember them.
Yes.
Cause them, Lord, to hear your word.
Yes.
Oh God, you died for them. So that they don't have to die. So that they don't have to go through their pain alone.
Yes.
Oh my God, remember those who have given you their all. Minister to them today. And rescue your people. Remember those who have joined online. Bless them abundantly.
Yes,
I pray. Remember the young sisters in our midst today. Sister Rochelle, who gave up her study time to be here. Father God, you owe no man anything. I pray you minister to her and to them and to all who have given their time today.
Hallelujah.
Oh God, a hundredfold blessing.
Hallelujah.
Oh mighty God, you said you're a God of covenant. Yes, Lord, I pray. Oh God, that they will do exceedingly abundantly. Oh God, more than they can imagine in their schoolwork. Oh mighty God, in the places where they need help today. Do it again, Father. And bless your people, I pray, in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm going to ask Minister Ruth to make her way. And while she's making her way, you may be seated. I just want to welcome very, very specially four persons who are here today. Crystal Smith, she's my daughter, quote unquote. I have many children. I have no children, but I have many children. Crystal Smith, and Crystal has come with three of our own mentees, our own daughters themselves, Caretta and Caressa. Can you all stand? And Caretta and Caressa, they are twins actually, and Janelle. We welcome you specially, specially. Can you give them a round of applause? As moderator, we have these very special, you know, privileges to so welcome some special people. You're all special.
Praise
my God. Reverend Jenny, Eugenie, what a special set of people. We all are, my God. Well, Sister Ruth is going to pray the blessing on the ministry of broken but blessed. And afterwards, we're going to get some direction to be in the refreshment. Is that so? Bless God.
Go ahead, my sister.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Today, I am honored to be in the kingdom. And I'm honored to be in this house.
Hallelujah.
And I'm honored to be in the ministry.
Hallelujah.
Of Sister Ffrench.
Look at that.
And each and everyone who are here. Let us pray.
Praise God.
Eternal and righteous God, we glorify your name. For there is none like you. You are El Shaddai. Father, you give us beautiful ashes. Strength for fear,
yes, yes.
Gladness for mourning,
yes, yes,
and
yes.
Peace for despair. We know the potter. We are in the potter's hands.
Yes, yes.
Oh, we were broken, but now we are mending.
Hallelujah.
And Lord, we thank you that you don't keep broken. You mend us.
Amen.
And Lord, some is still broken and there is still work to be done.
Yes, yes.
Lord, I pray your blessing upon this ministry.
ministry. I pray that this ministry will grow a thousandfold with young people. I pray that our life will be a light in this world of darkness. Amen. That people will see the light in us and come to know you. I pray, oh God, for each and every one who are in the position of leadership. We thank you for the pastors. Thank you for those who are in ministry. Lord, I pray a special blessing upon Sister Ffrench right now.
Yes.
I pray, oh God, a woman of many acts.
Yes, yes.
Lord, you have to be a woman of God, to be humble, to wear all these hats. And Lord, you not flaunting it in anybody's face, for God, unless to God, we never know these things.
Hey,
but thank God, Jesus, because she have our one year, we never know. And if we never come home, know it. And when everything finished, never ask her about it. God, you like when you swim straight. You like when we keep it real. You are a God all by yourself. And Lord, you choose to pour out your spirit upon your people. Lord, pour out upon us today more and more. Thank you, Lord, for your many blessings. Let every heart that leave here leave being watered. Like the tree that is planted by the rivers of water, so we can bring much fruit in our season.
Amen.
Our leaves shall not wither, and whatsoever we do, we shall prosper, because we belong to our true and living God. Have your way today. Bless your man servants in the house. Thank you for Rakar. Lord, a young man, we were young together. I was much older than him. But God, this young man have a desire to serve you. And God is implanted. God, you plant him in your house. And God, hallelujah, you have allowed his life to be an example to young men in society. Yes, we fall, but we rise. And you don't keep our past against us. Lord, you mend us. And as my sister said, you have to look up to see the cross, because he covered us with grace.
Hallelujah!
Have your way, Jesus. Thank you again for this ministry. Thank you for the host of this panel. Thank you for everyone. And may we leave today being watered and take away something. Because as my sister said, this ministry is for us.
Yes.
So we thank you, Lord, that she answered the call. We tell you thanks for everyone that ministered today. Special blessing upon everyone who are here. Let them come back and testify of this day. Because God, you say, the unto the word that come from your mouth. And it will accomplish that which is set out. And we tell you thanks for your many blessings in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let me hear the church say amen.
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 Thank you, Sister Ruth.
Can I just get something over? And where's the musician? The musician about?
Hey.
I was searching for love in the wrong places. They all came and said that they loved me. We never knew that their love was so empty. It caused me pain, misery, and strife. So we went to the well to get some water. Said they go up and some young fella. Never knew that he was the savior. Come to reveal my dirty behavior.
Hey.
No, Satan, Jesus Christ, say your worst nightmare.
Yeah.
No, we don't pet and call the demons because we talk to demons like dogs.
Yeah.
No, what kind is wrong when I get my church and the gates of
hell?
Come down. Set on wrapped up, tied up. All right.
Praise God, praise God.
I was searching for love in the wrong places. They all came and said that they loved me. We never knew. Give me a story and strike.
develop a ministry. Okay? Awesome. Over to you.
Hi everyone. So as we are about to go get refreshments, I just want to sing this song. It's called Bless Me. And I just want to pronounce this blessing on you guys. The Lord bless you and keep you.
Yes, yes.
Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace.
Hallelujah.
The Lord bless you. Lord.
Rest, remain, and abide with us all until Jesus comes. Let me hear all.